Okay, here we go. Thinking about cutting through the park. This will not be a speed run, at least not in the beginning. Maybe when the coffee kicks in. Woo-hoo. Watch out then.
You know me.
You know me if you've seen my videos. Now I feel like even with sunglasses I don't see as well as I do without sunglasses. And that's one of the reasons why I don't wear a helmet. I haven't on motorcycles for years.
I feel like it obstructs my vision and I really can't see what's going on and have more of a chance of getting into issues. So, I mean, you know, put myself at risk, but I tell everyone else they should wear a helmet and gear, especially if they're even new. I mean, it's like when you first ride a bicycle and you're young, you know, you're gonna wear a helmet, you're gonna wear all the safety gear. But then when you get older and you know what you're doing, I mean, shoot, I rode my motorcycle at 155 miles an hour with no helmet. So as long as you know what you're doing. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go to the park.
Here, I gotta go on the sidewalk for a little bit because that's the main road, and I don't want to go on the main road unless I'm going to do
50 miles an hour so you don't impede traffic. I think it's 40 mile an hour speed limit, so nobody's on the sidewalk, so you can go a little faster. I mean, it's all about safety, but more importantly, it's about other people's safety, not my safety. I'm the one doing this. It's just like if you skydive, you're putting in a risk of what happens in your hands and whoever packed the chute. And I used to skydive. And I tell you what, there's a lot of things in life you do that you take a risk. Getting in a car, even with a seatbelt on, you don't think that's a risk? Hell yeah, that's a risk. But you have to weigh the risk versus reward. I mean, if you take care of your equipment and you know that most likely it's safe, then you're good.